The OTSC Neo system is used for hemostasis, closure of perforations and fistulas, as well as for preventive tissue compression after resection in the GI tract. In this video, we will show you valuable tips for assembling and using the system. Further information on the system's components can also be found in our assembly instructions and in the assembly video in our media library. The identification codes on the packaging of the OTSC Neo system provide information on compatibility, cap depth, and clip tooth geometry. The first number refers to the maximum compatible outer diameter of the endoscope. The system is available in sizes 11, 12, and 14, as well as in a mini version. The second number indicates the cap depth. The variant with a 6 mm cap depth allows the mobilization of a larger amount of tissue and is universally applicable, but may slightly restrict visibility. Therefore, for cases where even better visualization and easier navigation in narrow lumens, as well as further limitation of the tissue amount are desired, a variant with a cap depth of 3 mm is also available. However, this variant is not compatible with the OTSC Twin Grasper. The letter stands for the clip tooth geometry. There are three different versions of the OTSC Neo clip. Type A with blunt teeth, Type T with pointed teeth, and Type GC with longer pointed teeth, specifically for the treatment of perforations and lesions in the stomach. Before use, check the compatibility of the endoscope and the application cap using the scope check. The endoscope is compatible if it is too large for the upper opening but fits through the lower opening. This step is particularly important as endoscopes often deviate from their specifications. The OTSC Neo system is designed for use with standard flexible endoscopes with a working channel diameter of at least 2.8 mm. If the system is used in combination with an accessory device, the working channel diameter must be at least 3.2 mm. Moisten the tip of the endoscope with water or endoscopic lubricant to facilitate assembly. During assembly, ensure that the thread does not become trapped between the cap and the endoscope tip. To do this, wind up the thread before placing the cap until the application cap touches the endoscope tip. Gently place the cap onto the endoscope tip and align it so that the release thread runs vertically through the working channel. Then push the cap onto the endoscope tip as far as it will go. The stoppers serve as a support for clip application, and the cap depth limiter prevents too much tissue from being drawn into the cap. Continue winding the release thread onto the hand wheel until slight tension is felt. Do not press the cap against your hand or a table during assembly to avoid damaging the endoscope tip or injuring your hand. When introducing an instrument, the release thread should remain slightly tensioned to prevent it from wrapping around the instrument and hindering or impeding clip application. Therefore, before introducing the instrument, turn the hand wheel clockwise until slight tension is felt and press it against your body to prevent the thread from unwinding. Ensure that the tip of the instrument is sufficiently retracted into the cap before clip application. To ensure that the instrument does not move during clip deployment, fix it to the endoscope with your fingers. This prevents the clip from being applied to the instrument shaft and the instrument from being fixed to the tissue. The OTSC anchor helps to precisely align and fix the target tissue at the cap opening during clip deployment, especially in fibrotic or hard tissue and for fistula closure. The OTSC anchor is operated with both hands for better control and force transmission. Ensure that the instrument is not kinked or coiled during use, but as straight as possible. Position the anchor so that, when the endoscope working channel is at 6 o'clock, it is also positioned at 6 o'clock, just below the lesion. This allows the lesion to be drawn into the cap space above. In some cases, it may not be possible to fully mobilize fibrotic tissue into the cap. In this case, it is sufficient to pull the tissue to the edge of the cap with the OTSC anchor and then deploy the clip. The clip jumps slightly forward when released and is thus able to grasp tissue in front of the cap. The OTSC twin grasper, with its two separately controllable jaws, supports controlled closure of lesions, enabling closure from serosa to serosa. The twin grasper is also operated with both hands for better control. The instrument must not be kinked or coiled during use to ensure good force transmission. For necessary closure of perforations and reduced visibility, for example in the colon, placing a TTS clip slightly distal to the perforation can help to easily relocate the site. Turn the hand wheel as quickly as possible to safely release the clip. The blue ring provides immediate visual confirmation that the OTSC NeoClip has been deployed. To prevent the endoscope from slipping during clip application, hold the endoscope in front of the patient's mouth before application. Excessive pressure on tissue can make clip application difficult or even impossible. Therefore, avoid pressing the endoscope tip firmly against the lesion and release some air from the lumen before tissue mobilization. Both measures reduce tissue tension and thus facilitate tissue mobilization. If the clip could not be deployed, insert an instrument into the working channel before withdrawing the endoscope so that it protrudes slightly from the application cap. This serves as a safety measure to avoid complications in case the clip is accidentally deployed while withdrawing the endoscope.